Food and water are basic human needs, even if provided artificially. Unfortunately, many in the medical community will designate artificial nutrition and hydration as extraordinary care in and of themselves, with no reference to any state of affairs. Contrary to this view, artificially administered food and water are not in themselves extraordinary care. They are within the realm of basic human care. Giving food or water to another person is always a charitable act, and one that parallels a basic human need. Only in situations when the body is unable to assimilate them, or they become harmful to the patient, are artificially administered food and water classified as extraordinary care and properly suspended. We can imagine our reaction, or the reaction of any Christian or person of goodwill, if someone were to refuse to change a terminally ill person's adult diaper or bedding because, well, they're going to die anyway. We would rightly be appalled. We expect that these basic human services will be provided until the person actually dies. In a similar way, this is how moral truth approaches food and water. It's a service that is not negotiable so long as the person's body can receive and benefit from the food and water, even if these are given artificially. The fact that a person is unable to feed himself or drink water himself and must therefore be provided these basic human needs artificially does not in any way preclude medical professionals or family members from providing this basic care to the patient.